everybody. For today's game, I'm playing AD Bruiser Leona in the top lane, and we're going to become, you know, we're building Bruiser, but honestly, with the Bruiser items this season, we become a legit assassin at the same time. We went PTA just to maximize our damage for the early game up against a Riven. We took Ignite. We've got flat HP, and I don't know if this Riven knows what's about to hit her. Look at that PTA proc. Look at the damage. Look at the moves. So that is half of this Riven's HP. Now, I did have bone plating, so bone plating is kind of busted. Uh-huh. It looks so troll, and it is. Don't get me wrong. But AD, like, Doran's played Leona, and, like, Leona has, like, insane base stats for early on the game that against a champion like Riven, who requires like a lot of like skill and outplay or whatever, Leona counters that by just brain dead beating you down. Yeah, just beating you with base stats. So, you know. Twilight fades. We could probably beat up this Riven again. I'm gonna be level 3 when she gets back to lane. Oh man, that is some big time damage. Yeah, I don't think this Riven knows what's going on. I'm kind of running Oom. I think I kind of want to go tier item. Tier item, Trinity Force, and then maybe like Sundered Sky and Eclipse. Just kind of maximize my damage. If I was more confident in my Leona top gameplay, I'd probably go for a dive there. But you know what? We got a pretty good lead. The Riven has one CS. We'll take it as it is. So I'm going to go tier. I'll go a long sword and refill potion. Let me get back up to full HP. So probably this game, I'm gonna go Trinity Force, because Trinity Force, the damage on Spellblade, insane. And you can just spam your Q over and over again. So we're gonna do this. We're gonna go Manimmune. Then we're gonna build probably either Sundered Sky or Eclipse. And then build the other one after. And we're just gonna be legit one-shotting people. And the amount of stats I'm gonna be getting from a W is gonna kind of make up for any stats I'm not building. Later. So, you have champs like Garen in the top lane who get a bunch of free stats from his W. Well, Leona gets that at level 1, whereas Garen has to, like, I think his prerequisite, he has to, like, CS or something. So, I'm just gonna get my PT proc. I traded with her there, even though it was in a big wave, just so that the wave didn't crash. So, sometimes you trade in top lane, not just for the fact that you're, you know, wanting to, you know, trade and beat up your opponent. But sometimes you trade just for a wave position. So remember that in your games that, like, sometimes it's okay to take, like, a bad trade if it forces your enemy into a bad wave spot. Like, look at this Riven right now. I have an advantage on her, and she can't really do anything about it, right? Okay, my Evelyn jungle. Okay, just reached level 4. Nice. I think the enemy team invaded her red side early, so she had to do some weird pathing. Oh no, Blitzcrank's up. I'm on the way! Okay, surely we collapse on this. Oh, nice. Easy peasy. You know what, let me grab this one grub. Alright, I'm gonna grab the one grub and then run away. That is a lot of damage I've taken. Oh my gosh, these grubs smack. Alright, can I back in time? I believe I can. So, let's see. We'll probably grab Sheen here. Oh, could grab Phage as well, or this, just for the attack speed. Let's grab this. Hearthbound Axe probably gives us the most stats. So, the reason we could back there is because look at our wave. It's still in a really good spot, even though I roamed grubs. And that's exactly what I traded that Riven for, is for this wave position, so that I could roam without really giving up my position. Man, this Evelyn is just really wanting those grubs, man. She already died once going from. Maybe she should just clear some camps. Oh, I missed those two minions because my W. I should have spaced the W. It's like a really close trade mid.
Shut down. First light approaches.
Killing spree. Okay. Easy peasy top line kill. This Riven's just getting beat up, man. Now remember, Leona does, I gain a lot of effectiveness from my sunlight if I'm playing with, you know, my jungler. Unfortunately, my jungler this game is, you know, a little bit sus, a little bit sussy, not doing the best here, but it's alright. I'll amp up my team's damage later, easy peasy. Let me take it back. The reason I'm taking it back instead of going for a play is like, you see how fast Riven gets back to lane? Yeah, I can't really mess with that. Okay. Looks like my bot lane is doing decent. Kai'Sa's up CS. They've got a cringe Nautilus mid to counter the APSS and an Ahri. I believe Ahri will do a lot more later. Nautilus is not. He's literally building full tank. It's. Basically, Nautilus is like Galio, but better in the 1v1, whereas Galio is better for roams.
Rally to me.
Oh, man. Yeah, so they got Nautilus mid, like, as a like a support kind of character, beating up. You know, of course I'm playing Leona. Alright. Let's go, Riven. Come on, fight me. You scared of the Leona top, brother? I would be. I don't have boots, but I'm ready to throw down. I'm just like going straight stats wherever I can. I think if I engage into her with my E, then the trade isn't good. But if she comes into me and I Q, and then I use my E to follow up after and get a second Q, that's where my trade's gonna be ridiculous. Man, that Hecarim is literally just sitting mid this whole game. I really want this cannon. Yeah, look at that trade. So if I lead with my E, then she just EWs and gets away. But if I walk up and I land my Q, then I can get a second Q by the end of the trade. So it's kind of like how you want to be playing it up against another melee. Oh my. I tried getting both those minions to my E and my E just didn't do damage. Oh wait, she's still here. Bye, Riven. She really thought she could stay on her turret. I thought she knew better. I thought I taught her over that lesson already. Well, you gotta teach the Riven's lesson a couple times. A lot of Riven players are a little bit slow. Alright, there we go. I'm getting that plate. My grubbies. And wow, well, yeah, we got Trinity Force at 10 minutes. We're kind of smacking. We're up 50 CS on this Riven top. We're up 3 levels. She is not having a good time. We're stacking up our tier that way we can go into our mirror mana. Not too shabby.
Rally to me.
And Nautilus is taking 0 damage. Just. Full-on tank, pressing W. The most skillful thing you've ever seen. It's like Smolder caught up in CS a little bit. I guess he got his AoE Q for his stacks. They just reworked Smolder, too. Let me know in the comments down below if you want to see Smolder. God, this Evelynn is just inting for every grub. It is crazy. That guy took You know, this Grubb's thing a little bit too seriously. Like, I was on the Grubb hype train very early on the season. But honestly, here's how Grubb's is. Grubb's is like a win more mechanic. If you sacrifice gold and experience to go for Grubb's when you're not already hard winning, like say the game's like even, you're trolling. In fact, I see a lot of games where both junglers kind of just ignore Grubb's and the game is just better. It is better quality. So I'm actually E second. My Q doesn't reduce cooldown, but my E does. This helps the stick potential. Okay, I don't think Hecarim wants to mess with me. If I hit that E, I'm pretty sure I kill Hecarim too. I'm gonna reset my health bar. I don't want Hecarim's ult to like come back up. Alright, let's see. They're all AD, so I can just go Tabby's. I would consider Merc Treads if they had more CC, because I want to be autoing a ton with this setup, just to, you know, proc my PTA if anything. Wait, Evelyn? You don't want that kill? Maybe the Hecarim saw Evelyn, I'm not sure. This is a rough jungler, and whereas their jungler is just constantly camping mid.
Glory. An ally has been slain.
It's like Riven wants in the action. I'm just gonna have to push in top hard. I mean, Riven used R, so there is that. I'm gonna use my W here just for Trinity proc. Oh man, look at this attack speed. Me hitting this turret, I'm bashing this shit in. I'm gonna walk here. Oh. You know, I'll just walk away from that. I don't want them to like three man me. I mean, I'm pretty tanky because I'm Leona. I mean, Blitz's full combo did negative damage there. Let's see if I can dodge this hook. I think I'll range it. Okay. You know what? I set up a kill for Mavlin. Easy peasy. Alright, you know what? I'll fist bump Evelyn. She's been kind of trolling our mid, but you know, it's what it is. Alright, let's go main immune. You know, I would consider Titanic Hydra 2. I think I just get more out of building other bruiser items, so. Titanic might be nice for later, though. I basically 1v2'd their bot lane, and I think they use summons, too. That being said, I did have Ignite for the Smolder. The Ignite adds in a good amount of extra pressure. That's why the Riven took it, too. Nice. Just got two dashes left. Man, that Hecarim is fast as hell with that ghost. I'm gonna dodge, that way I ignore the stack. Man, Leona's auto-Q-auto is so fluid, I love it. I don't like that she's taking turret gold from me, but, you know, it's fine. I actually love Leona's auto-attack animation, it's fantastic. I need a little bit more for this. me see if I can roam on mid. Oh my god, what a combo. Riven just got frickin' deleted. Yeah, we can get Rift. We can just secure every objective topside since I am gapping this Riven right now. Got my mana immune. I'll turn into mirror mana very quickly, and we're about to do so much damage. Let me see if I can make it to dragon. All right, if we can stall, it'd be great. If not, it's what it is. What it is. We can fight after if need be. Oh, there's a ward here. Oh, I missed my E. Nice. Set up Kai'Sa for easy kill on the Nautilus. Let's walk towards mid. So, we dominate top lane, then we're dominating basically every team fight. I kind of want the shield from riding the Herald. So, don't mind if I do. Kind of want the shield again. This Hecarim thought for a second he can engage it. Man, they're focusing the wrong target. Oh, nice. Bard ulti actually decent. Okay, I'm dead. Abandoned! I got abandoned! Alright, let's see. In this, you know, since I'm team fighting a lot, I'm gonna go Center Sky. If I was splitting more, then I would go Eclipse. Eclipse is better for, like, one-on-one because of the straight damage you get every, I think, at 6 seconds with Eclipse. Yeah, 6 seconds, it does a big time max health damage. Oh, damn it. That was a good flip zone. That was a super good flip zone. This Evelynn hasn't wanted to be part of any fight other than going for grubs. He has a Medjai's with zero stacks. He's very confident in himself. You know, I respect that. Alright, need some more farm. I will protect you. I'm hitting this just so I can get my mana immune up.
An ally has been slain.
Oh no, I should have eaten the blitz earlier. You know, I cannot judge the flight on Smolder. Okay, Leona is like doing, like, this champion does legit damage. I'm just like straight owning their ADC. Chosen of the Sun. Alright, let me push this out. I need 600 more gold for Sundered. You know, they are doing nothing but chasing an Ahri around all game.
And
it's literally gonna get them the loss. I think he dies to ignite. Yep. Literally just soloed their Hecarim. Oh. Oh, okay. You just walk in the upland then. That's fine with me. This is why I have the mirror mana, by the way. Look at my mana. Hey, hey, while we're here, I might as well do this, right? We just killed their whole team. Maybe I should have saved mana for my W, just because I'm tanking. There we go. Alright, not too shabby. I've got Sunder Sky in base. I'm gonna go grab that in a second. Oh, maybe I should cover a top wave. We might give up the dragon, but that's fine. Alright, got Sunder Sky. Let's build in towards the eclipse. So let's grab longsword for now. Alright, they're just 5 mana Gario. This is unreal. Oh my god. They're just 5 maning Ahri every time they can get. They literally could have done dragon by now. Since I literally went topside, but now I don't think they even get dragon. Okay, I'm just gonna annihilate their whole team. Okay, Ghost Flash. Let's go kill this guy. Yeah, like, I cannot stress you guys enough, man. Like, objective focus. If you're not, like, if you're just going for kills, you're gonna lose games. You can go for kills, you know, outside of, like, objective timers, like, easy peasy, like, looking for picks and whatever. But yeah, doing what they're doing up my Ahri, yeah, that's just bad. You know, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna shadow Ahri here. And I'm pretty sure they're about to go and 5 man Ahri, just like they've been doing. And then I'm gonna be there and we're gonna 2v5.
First light approaches.
Yeah, no, no. I'm here for the fight. Oh, wow! Ah! Ahri's top that has summoned the Hecarim. Ruby DC? Maybe it's just typing? I'm not sure. Oh, hey, Blitz is here too. Oh. I'll for it. Y'all can finish it. Yeah, it is actually unreal how bad they are at their, the rotation. They see kills and nothing else. Oh, going on me, huh? Oh. That's fine. Oh, my Baron ended. Your charm? My Sunder Sky healing is popping off, by the way. Oh my gosh. Oh, we didn't kill him. Oh, hey, Evelyn. doing the split push mid wave, because, you know, it's good for the champion. I'm pretty sure I just bought this Sunder Sky. And it has healed me almost 2,000. On top of how tank I am with just my W, We assassinated the enemy team. Hope you guys enjoyed that video. Let me know in the comments below what you want to see next. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys all have a wonderful day. Bye for now.